Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Would you believe me if I told you this handwritten note was actually made by my laptop? Yep, not typed, not printed, but literally handwritten style, and it's generated by my laptop by just writing few lines of Python code. So I found several online tools, but that didn't truly work. So I built it on my own, and I just wanted to share that knowledge with you guys. And the best part is it will not require any internet, not any API or anything. It's just Python and your creativity. That's it. You'll be able to customize your font size, color, even the line backgrounds and everything. And of course, you can fool your friends also by just showing that you have actually written this, but it is your computer who have written this. So brilliant, isn't it? So let's dive into our video. Now before I start, I want to request you, please do like, share and subscribe. That's going to really motivate me to make more this similar kind of videos, and it's going to also help YouTube algorithm to share this video with many viewers like you. So let's invoke our PyCharm IDE. So on my previous videos, I have showed you how to detect any human face. So I have showed you how to detect human faces. You can see it is clearly detecting all the faces. You can watch that tutorial. Now let's create a new project and give this project name as Python Handwritten, and check this create a welcome script and click on create. So that's going to immediately start creating our project. So our project is already created. Let's go to terminal and install one very important Python library called PIL. So just simply type pip install PIL and just simply hit enter. So that's going to immediately start installing our PIL library. So this PIL library is basically modern fork of the traditional PIL, or powerful image library of Python. And you can see that our PIL is rightly installed. So let's delete all the stuff from here and let's start writing our code. So the first step is to import PIL. So import image draw and image font. It will be form. Next, import text wrap. And now you need to provide the text that you want it to be printed. So you can write your own text over here. I'm going to just copy it from here. By the way, you can follow our GitHub account and you'll be able to get entire source code, from this project text to handwriting. I'm going to provide that link in the description. Don't worry, here in this video I'm going to write all the codes and going to explain it to you. You can follow this later on also. So write your own text over here that you want it to be handwritten. And next step will be to set the path of the font that you want to use. So you can just simply go to your browser and just simply type Google font and go to their website and just simply search over here handwritten. So as soon as you type that, it's going to show you this calligraphy handwritten. So select that, it will filter it accordingly, and you can see it's already showing lot of search results, right? You can choose anyone you like. So I'm going to choose probably this one, this homemade apple. So get font, and I'm going to download this one. So it is properly downloaded. So here is our file. So let's extract it. And here is our font TTF. So this is what we need to paste it over here. So right click and copy it. And let's browse to our project. So just select our project, right click and click on open in Explorer. So that's going to open our project, this PyCharm projects. Go inside our project and right click and paste that font that you just now downloaded, this homemade Apple, you can download any font you like. Alright, you can also Google, you know, like handwritten fonts, and it's going to show you a lot of, you know, websites, so you can, you know, try out different stuffs also. Main thing is you need to have a font file whose file name extension is TTF. Alright, so I have downloaded this as a sample. So now I'm going to use that. So homemade Apple. So homemade Apple dash regular TTF, and then I'm going to set font size. So font size. You can set any font size you want. I'm setting 32. You can try with different stuff also. Let's set width and height of our canvas. So let's set 700 by 1000, and then let's set the background. So image new, which will have couple of parameter. So I'll put RGB white. That's it. Next is we need to draw. So image draw dot draw, and we want our background, right? So that's it. Then the final step is to wrap that text and drawing it. So font equal to image font dot true type, then you need to set your font path and your font size, and finally you need to set the margin equal to 50, let's say, and set the offset value as well. So let's set 50 to offset as well, and then finally we need to iterate over text wrap. So text, and then we need to set width, let's set width as 40. And then we'll just simply draw our text. So margin offset line font, let's send the font font, and we'll be filling it with black color. So again, this is also configurable, you can configure it as per your requirement, and set the offset as well to font size plus 10, so it will be incremented by 10. And then comes the final step, that is to save our file. So background.save, let's give the file name something like handwritten.jpg, and you can get the output also on your console, so something like handwritten text JPG is generated successfully. That's it. So here what we are doing basically is we are wrapping the text so that it fits nicely on the page, and then we are drawing each line one by one, and we handle all the spacing between each word by offset. And text wrap basically helps to break the text into neat chunks. So I'm going to show you when we get that output. And here we are just basically creating that blank canvas, and here we are importing the font that we'd like to use, and we are setting the font size, and here is your text that you want it to be printed. So now just simply write this much and click on this run button, and you can see that it is showing some error. So that is mainly because here we have given one typo, so it is not RGB, it is RGB. So it's a mistake from my end. So it is RGB, that is red, green, blue. So just a typo from my end. So after that, just click on the run button and you can see the output also coming, handwritten JPG is generated successfully, and if you click on this text, you can see it is properly generated, right? But you can see it is cropped from the right side. So let's increase our canvas size a bit. So let's make it 800 and click on the run button again. So again it is generated, and this time you can see it is clearly shown over here and how realistic it is, right? So it really does look handwritten, doesn't it? So you can use this trick for writing notes, digital letters, or you can, you know, write a very nicely handwritten poem, or just for fun you can share this with your friends, colleagues, parents, and you can enjoy. And the best thing is you don't need to worry about your privacy. So it is exactly what you are doing on your own laptop, so you are not going to use any online tool in future, right? So yeah, so in my next video what I'm going to do is I'm going to merge all these files that you are seeing over here. So I'm going to merge these 3 or 4 JPEG files into a complete PDF file. So all the pages, you know, that I'm going to generate over here will be add up into just a single combined PDF file, and you can share that file and you can, you know, mesmerize your friends that look how beautiful your handwriting is, isn't it? So yeah, so for that, don't forget to like, share and subscribe and press that bell button to get notified. And you can follow our GitHub account and you can get your source code from here. Only thing is you need to change your font path over here. So whichever font you want, you need to just replace that, and rest you can just simply keep it what I have written over here. And if you want to learn more about these stuffs, you can always refer to our article. So again, all these things I'm going to provide right in our channel description. So you can get all those stuffs from our official site as well. So you can read all this. So it also has a source code over written over here. And you'll also get, you know, several Python projects on our channel as well. For example, this how to create a QR code, then how to detect human faces, and all that. You can even use Python to generate your speech as well. So all these things you will get on our channel already. So you need to just follow all these tutorials, and I have made video for each of these projects, so you can watch all those things on our channel as well. So yeah, that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. That's going to really motivate me to make more the similar kind of videos. So thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.